An unseen hand forces Ogonus from his feet and into a dense thicket skirting the stone path. A soothing voice murmurs in his ear as the sailor witnesses the passage of things only spoken of in tall tales, and even then, in whispers.
Be quiet for but a moment,
the voice counsels. Once the otherworldly creatures fade from sight, Ogonus pulls himself from the dust and gazes skyward. Before him, held aloft, is a handsome woman, replete with glory and power.
How many times must fair Athena save one man?
The immortal asks, her head tilted with uncommon grace, her eyes soft. Before words can form on Argonus's lips, she continues.
'Tis not a query to be answered so readily, sailor of the Argo. Shadows gather, she says. There is a blight upon this isle. Have you not seen its handiwork? The flesh of your companions no longer flesh. Their bones, that of the earth.
The woman's eyes drop.
I fear my own hand may have set these dire events into motion. For this, I will make amends. But know well, many of your brethren yet live, for I have seen them with my own eyes. Find them, Ogonus of Crete, and as I did for your father before you, I shall provide a boat and passage from this isle. You have the word of fair Athena.
Not a heartbeat later, the goddess is gone, and breath gladly returns to the sailor's lungs.